long-term investment.
Hey, folks, good morning and welcome to Smile Jamaica. It is morning time. It is Thursday, December 6th, almost Christmas. You see the beautiful decorations behind us. We welcome everyone on onespotmedia.com, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat at Smile Jam TVJ, and also on television, jamaica.com, not dot com. Always great to have you with us. As always, we have a fantastic show lined up, and good to have my co-host with me, Dahlia, who's showing you.
Dahlia Harris!
You're not related to Dalton, are you?
No, I'm not related, but I saw the man say Harris' name for Carl, and I saw it for Carl.
Oh, it's for Carl.
Harris! Sexy shrimpsy.
Oh, you know, me take me here, Carl, sexy.
No, one lady at Elsha, she said, may I ask her right name? She said, should I like the name? Her mother call her name, so she ate it. So she said, she named Sexy Shrimpsy.
Shrimpsy.
She sells shrimps. Sexy Shrimpsy. The other one named Sketchy. Guess what he does for a living? He sketches.
Which would be the reason, named Sketchy.
Yes.
Yes.
The next one, him named Outer Place, him named Sparrow. Dilly, you remember Sparrow? You have a name, Sparrow. So good morning to the folks at Elsha.
Good morning to Sexy Shrimpsy, Sketchy, and Sparrow.
And the folks at Celine.
At where?
Celine's. Then I went to New Jamil, and I said, I have to tell them morning. And
who is New Jamil? Neville.
They are on Hagley Park Road. But luckily, you can reach them because they're at the corner of Waltham and Hagley Park. So I went there, Sunji and Afua.
Remember a good one.
Well, them two names, when them tell me the two names, I say Sunji and Afua.
No, you remember good. Mm-hmm. Everything else is all
What's
right.
What's going on with you, youth?
Can't complain.
Can't complain?
No. Can't complain, give thanks.
You tush out this morning, man.
Me tush out?
Dush out. Dush out.
So I'm going to dush out all morning. What dush mean, by the way? Hold on, before me say, me like it. In Sheffield, before me say me like it, where douche me?
No, you take it already, you can't. You take it already.
You know, me go on road today, everybody will start.
Yeah, but you're douche.
douche. Whatever that means.
You're dapper and you're stosh, so you're douche.
Okay.
Douche out.
All right, yeah. All right. Me like douche then. Me like
you're douche out.
All right, what's up on the show this morning? I will tell you in a second. Well, you went
on today's show, even more letters to read to help out a few folks in need in time for the holidays.
And your holiday might be a little warmer if you hear from your folks in foreign, from greetings across the world rolls around.
And the world loves volunteerism. We tell you about the power of this great act from both the receiving and the giving end.
And he's giving you the music on the Smile stage, folks. You may remember Delando Colley from Rising Star some years ago, but now he's back to hit the Smile stage, as I said earlier. Mm-hmm. But nobody not hitting nothing until we do some hot topics.
Mm-hmm.
Well, hot topics. The front page says, charge them. Private sector wants persons to be held criminally responsible for findings at Petrojam. This is after the recommendations came out from the Attorney General.
Mm. The Auditor General.
The Auditor General. Mm. The recommendations by the POCJ. They're now saying that, I didn't read this part of the report, that Petrojam could not account for 600, or is how much that? I don't 600.
I mean, I don't know how much, but
684.
And just the money part.
That looks like 6 million. I don't know. Anyway, they said it could be 6 million barrels of oil missing. Mm. It valued at 5.2 billion over a 5-year period. 600684. How much that? That is more than 600. You can't 600 barrel value at 5.2 billion over a five-year period, and that the company spent, renew this one, US$21,000 or 2.6 million Jamaican to host two surprise parties, one for the former energy minister and one for the then chairman.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Howard Mitchell, who is president of the POCJ, said the toxic environment and the parties are also disturbing. But in terms of hard, cold facts, if 5 billion of fuel is missing, somebody should be investigated and prosecuted. He said that is taxpayers' money. I said yesterday that it was our money that put on the party. Well, apparently it's our money that them can't find the oil. The Prime Minister has said, and the word coming out of the Director of Communications and the Office of the Prime Minister, he says, and I quote, what we can say to you is that there will be definitive action and there will be definitive comments on what has been reported on by the Auditor General. And we are very sure that when that takes place, the people of Jamaica will be confident in the responses and what those additional actions will be. The other question I have, you see,
yeah,
it's always 5 years before somebody realizes
yeah.
it. Yeah. Eh? Always reach 5 years yeah. before somebody realizes it.
Yeah.
We can't find the if it is missing is the word I'm used. And it come up to $5.2 billion with a B. Then somebody never realize it after the first year or after the second year or after the third year. $5.2 billion.
Let me tell you why these things are painful to me. We not have it.
Nope.
Jamaica is not a country that have 5.2 billion for dash way. When you see the state of our health care, police every day can't get good pay. Teacher can't get good pay. State of the police station, them awful. $5.2 billion could do so much everywhere. So for you in your own self, believe, say, you have more value than everybody else in the country. Yeah, man. You be a guest at the country for a little bit.
I have an issue with the cake, too. We cost more than $100,000.
If it was personal money,
yeah,
I wouldn't have a problem.
Yeah.
But because I see people trying to justify it and saying, I had a cake that's that amount and I spent that. Me no care if you have it and you want to buy a bulla for $1,000, buy the bulla and
it's
your bulla.
Money. It's your money.
May your name be on it.
Yeah.
But
when is my money?
When is our money, which is Jamaica people,
yeah,
and people can't send them picnic to school,
yeah,
something is wrong with that. And I don't know how somebody in their head
yeah.
could have thought it was okay. May I say, never in Dubai or Qatar where we have it.
Yeah.
In Jamaica land we love, where every day people get up and say time's hard and we're being frugal and it's austerity time and so on. Madness. Utter madness.
Yep.
And
we shall hear and
none. If it is criminal, I don't know if it's just mismanagement or yep. negligence. If it's found to be criminal, them just have to go be a guest of the Jamaican government.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
All right, we move on.
And early, when you're in there, you understand why the state of the place is the state of the place. Because if $5 billion, we could have fixed it, you spend it.
And the people who spend the money never get invited to the party. And them buy the cake. Early childhood practitioners are now exempt from paying for police records, medical records, and food handlers permit. This came from the Minister of Education, Youth and Information. He said that early childhood practitioners who are employed to institutions that have applied for a certificate of registration with the Early Childhood Commission will benefit. He also said that practitioners are still required to renew these documents annually to be fully compliant with the requisite legislation. That's great news.
Because I don't want nobody to say them never renew them things and they never have the money. And if you're going to be dealing with food for the children, you must know, say, compliant. We are laughing. We're having a true. And we know if you have a police record, if you're around the people, yeah, man, we know these things. So nobody can, if the government go and say you don't have it, you're in trouble. You can't complain it free. So go. Wonderful. Okay.
Yeah, Richard, but it's not, I know, so that one that's spell. So, Not a word, you called me. So me and Richard have a little conversation. Him send me one, but we don't think I said that one.
No.
What's the next one?
Then it's called Raquel Rakadush.
Yep.
Brazilian doctors are reporting the world's first baby born to a woman with a uterus transplanted from a deceased donor. 11 previous births have used a transplanted womb, but from a living donor, usually a relative or friend. Experts said using uteruses from women who have died could make more transplants possible. 10 previous attempts using deceased donors in the Czech Republic, Turkey, and the US have failed. But the baby girl was delivered last December by a woman born without a uterus because of a rare syndrome. That's interesting. It's interesting, and it could be a great development, you know, because there are a lot of women. As I said, this one's born with a rare disease. Some, because a woman doctor, myomectomy, then they remove fibroids. After a while, I'm telling you, you have to remove you have to do a hysterectomy and whatever. So there's hope for women who may need to have a transplant. And it's difficult for a living person to take out their uterus and give you, yeah? So a deceased person. So cool. Let's hope it develops into something that they're able to duplicate effectively across the world.
All right, the final one is that the Youth View Awards will not be held next year. This is according to organizers, an elegant affair. They say the task of producing the event has taken a toll on staff. It's been going on for a while. Statement continued to say the level of production that the YVA is required, both mentally and physically, to bring it to life has taken a toll and has resulted in us taking a hiatus next year to refill our well and evaluate if we will go forward. We are beyond thankful for the journey and are resting it at God's feet that all things are in divine order. Love and light. I've been nominated a couple of times.
Yeah.
Never win, but thank you so much for those who have nominated me. They had categories like the Icon Award, Lifetime Achievement, Humanitarian, Song, Music, Video, Dancing, Album of the Year, all kinds of stuff.
It's heartbreaking because the YVA is one of those awards for a country that has done so much with music and continues to globally impact music. We still can't seem to have a major music awards. So the YVAs, for me, kind of stood in the gap and allowed young people to, you know,
express themselves.
Yeah, and interface stuff with artists and people. Last year they introduced theater.
Yeah.
So the YVAs was a nice little.
Yeah, it
was more than awards, you know?
Speaking of theatre, what are going on with, you know, buy a theatre?
Buy one for me now.
We don't have enough theatre space in Jamaica?
I don't think so. Some people think so. I don't think so.
You
well, in Jamaica.
The amount of plays you have, you wouldn't make back your money, seriously. You know, just rent it
Well, the money I pay to rent, better made it up.
Yeah.
Buy one place. So that's the reality. Why me just can't never take a break? It's finding somewhere because to do a theater space to me is more than just a play. People have to get proper parking, proper security. The bathroom have to stay good. And so it's finding a place.
Find a place, find out how much it is.
And you'll purchase it for me.
I won't, but we can go talk to some people and get some money. I'm serious. I'm very serious. Find a place.
What Harris said? You're so bad, Harold. I'm not even going to repeat what you said.
I would, but them done the money, so.
Yeah, I wouldn't repeat what you said.
Them you done
see,
the
I'm
going to
say that as a joke now, and next thing, I build my place, and I go write Petra Jam and say, can you donate as a corporate social responsibility? And then I go send me the dip on TV and make fun of them. So I'm not, I'm not laughing, you know.
Oh no, you get me invited. Yeah, everybody know me, you know me get invited.
Let me tell you though, I want to say good morning to the staff at Petra Jam. Because every time these things come up, like I saw a couple of them the other day, and they were, it's like everywhere people see them because them have on the Petra Jam clothes, people say, and all the staff, they're not. They're some really honest, hardworking Jamaicans at Petrojam. And I want to tell them good morning and tell them for whole of them.
Yeah, which is true. Good morning, folks.
Yeah.
All right, I have one birthday. Happy birthday, Lachi. It's from Tia and family. Here is Lachi. Lachi, I hope you have a great day today and wish you all the very, very, very best. But I wish that police officer happy birthday again. No one remember to do it yesterday.
Why? Are you wrong there?
No, it's a nice birthday, so I just want to say. Because I don't want to break the law, break any rules, but I wouldn't mind that officer lock me up. And officer, because I know the rules and I'm not going to do anything that I went wrong where you could put me under house arrest. I mean, I think would be ideal, because
I'm guessing this is not a male officer.
What?
I'm guessing it's not a male officer we're talking about.
You can guess all you want,
I'm guessing. From Mr. It's gone in a while.
Yeah. I'm just saying, because I am not a flight risk. You know, like, plus, me not a passport anyway, so we couldn't go away in the middle of our runway. So, officer.
I've never said passport. My passport expired.
Oh, sorry. Well, you can't come with me.
No, I'm not here with you. This is Jordan. happy birthday to Jordan from your mom, Tamara. All right. And Jordan's nanny. Jordan nanny, me tell him your name. I mean, reach me in. Not Jordan's nanny, the other kid's nanny. Jordan is a big boy. Jordan will cost me some, the lady I'm nanny.
Your phone's on.
No, because Arrow take till next week.
So you don't understand the whole up thing.
Him not done yet?
Him done long time, sure. You don't understand.
Wait, no man. Neville, no rush me. I like when you rush me.
If you have more.
Me not like when you rush me.
I'm not rushing.
Come and make you talk about the female. Me make you talk. The Wi-Fi in it.
How about going?
Me not know nothing. No, going. All right. See, today which day? Today is what day?
December
the 6th.
The entire day.
I didn't get to wish Jean Laurie Chin happy birthday yesterday.
Hey, Mrs. Laurie
Chin. And it was her birthday, and Richie Stevens as well. It is Kenesha Gordon's birthday. And I.T. Ellis. I.T. your birthday? Jomo, happy birthday. Troy Cummings, Suzanne Mogg, Boswell, Amy, Wagwami General, Casey and Collins, and Adrian Brown, Carlton Ricketts.
Okay.
Happy birthday.
Where's the food, Joe? Happy birthday, folks. Have a great day.